Okay, turning it on. Okay, now comes instant stop.
Hi guys, you might have seen the instantaneous dead stop function in many of the cordless drill machines and electric screwdrivers. So today in this video, I'm going to teach you how it occurs in the cordless drill machine or electric screwdriver and how you can also do it at home. And it's very easy. Now guys, this what you see is a 24 volts, 500 watts permanent magnet DC motor used for making e-bike. So with this motor, I'm going to show you how the DC motors usually perform when connected to a battery. You see, so much high starting torque. Now what I wanted to show you was, when I connect this and remove it afterwards, the motor continues to run. It's not at a dead stop, okay? You see, it continues to run. Still running. It's not at a dead stop. So let's bring it to dead stop. So for that you will be needing a single push double throw switch. This what you see is rated at 220 volts and up to 15 amperes, and this is the max double throw switch I had. So guys, here as you can see that I've connected three wires, this one and this one, and all the three wires are connected on one side of the switch and the other side is completely open. You see, I've left out this side because this function is possible with just these three terminals. So let's do the connections. So the first part is taking the two wires from the DC motor and take one, leave the other one behind, and connect it to the middle terminal of the switch. Red one is the middle, and the other terminals, this one and this one, choose any of the two, any one of the two, and connect it to the battery, any terminal of the battery. Here I've connected it to the negative terminal of the battery. Now when I will connect it, it will start running, okay? You see? Now let's turn it off. You see, it is not running anymore. That's the simple switch function. Okay, so now comes the stopping part, the instant dead stopping part. So for that, take the other terminal of this DC motor and the other left out terminal from the switch, okay, and connect them together like this. But one terminal from the battery has been left out. This is the tapping point which will be connected to the battery positive terminal. Okay, starting it. Sorry, actually this terminal is corroded. You see the corrosion. So for that, I'm going to use this clip to keep it in contact with the battery terminal, and now it should work. Okay, starting it. Let's dead stop it. You see, instant power stop. This is how they do it in a cordless drill machine or an electric screwdriver. Once again, super start and super stop. Dead stop, just like a disc brake. Now guys, the explanation behind it is, when I push the switch to one side, the terminal of the motor gets connected to the battery and the motor starts running at a really high speed. But as soon as I push the switch to the other side, the pushing of the switch not only disconnects one of the terminals of the motor from the battery, but it also short circuits the two terminals of the motor, creating a heavy load, in which case the motor is actually acting as a really loaded generator.